This conference will now be recorded.
Good morning, everyone. The webinar shall start in a short while from now. Kindly follow the instructions which are displayed on the screen. Please mute your mic and disable the webcam throughout the session to conserve the bandwidth and for smooth live streaming. Kindly do not post any messages when the speaker is sharing the screen. If you have any questions for the speaker, kindly post it in the chat box. Your questions will be answered by the resource person at the end of the session. The link for the feedback form will be posted in the chat box after the session is completed. Kindly fill the feedback form and be ensured that you will be generating the e-certificates. E-certificates will be sent only to the participants who fill the feedback form. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Mrs. Revati Devi Mathur, in charge Villamari Degree College. On behalf of Villamari Degree College for Women, I welcome you all to the national webinar. Welcome to Villamari Degree College for Women, a college that believes in bringing the change and making a difference. A college with a proven history of academic excellence. We believe that the power of thought can change attitudes, people, and society. With a substantial work stint of almost three decades, Villa Consortium is dedicated in providing a professional learning community that works collaboratively to ensure that students are focused and committed and to encourage all young women to be confident, caring, and motivating while becoming contributing members of the community. Villamari Degree College stands as an undisputed leader over the years, rising to the zenith of educational excellence, which is made possible by our visionary and guiding force, Dr. Philomena, founder, director, and correspondent of Villamari Education Society. She is a bridge builder connecting to the faculty, students, and parents, and also proffering solutions to the situations and adapt to new educational trends. She is the capability to disarm the challenges and able to stand out at times of educational challenges like these. We envisage that Villamari Degree College shall be a thriving, dynamic, and inspiring educational environment that produces self-directed learners with 21st century skills and stimulates students of diverse ethnicity invest in and benefit from public education, making them socially responsible. Villamari cherishes utmost importance on the partnership we form with students, families, and the community with the legacy for over 29 years. We ensure that each student acquires the knowledge, skills, and core values necessary to achieve personal success and to enrich the community, and this makes us distinctively the top-notch institution ranked as the second best degree college in the state of Telangana. The college has its unique philosophy. Change is constant, and today's webinar, ICT Embedded Education, revolves around this change. the world is confronting during this stemming global health crisis. The new normal of digitization in every sector has taken the dominance and is ruling. There has been a paradigm shift when we ponder about the education sector. Classroom teaching is out of question now, and chalk talk is now remote and soft. The digital learning is the new trend across the globe, which demands the pedagogy to revamp their teaching skills. The current educational scenario demands the teaching fraternity as to how we transcend the innovative teaching methodology using the information, communication, and technology. Today, we are delighted and honored to host the national webinar on ICT embedded education and integration of teaching, learning, and assessment with ICT tools, hosted by the Department of Computer Science in association with IQAC of Villamari Degree College for Women. I thank you all for taking time out and being here today. We are pleased that delegates are in attendance in the webinar today, being from 27 states of our country. I welcome you all. I realize that you are fully dedicated to the session that will follow. The webinar is principally designed to promote excellence in teaching, learning, and ICT admissions towards technology-driven teaching. I hope this webinar will highlight on the valuable inputs which can positively impact the faculty-student connect with technology. I wish you a very fruitful and a productive meeting. Thank you. I now request Mrs. Gayatri, Head Department of Computer Science, Villamari Degree College, to take over the proceedings of the webinar. Over to you, Mrs. Gayatri.
Thank you, ma'am. Today's education has changed over time to accommodate the ever-evolving modern processes world. The education system has been reconstructing its variables. The understanding of space and time has transcended the conventional physics. The institutions of higher education demand a change in the conventional chains of teaching approach. The exchange and interaction of ideas, thoughts, concepts should stem from critical thinking. Innovative approaches, both for teaching and evaluation, should be adopted in addition to impart immense value to the skill development and understanding of ever-changing dynamics. But the never of the need of the hour is to create skilled and professionally competent human resources that can only be accomplished through information and technology. We are all in unprecedented times. The whole world has converged to digitization. Every sector is under the state of this novel virus. If there are frontline warriors, doctors, and policemen who have been in service nonstop, the pedagogues are nevertheless warriors. Today's session is about understanding, building up, destabilizing, and reconstructing new dimensions to teaching and innovative pedagogy. The session will equip you with some interesting pedagogy because it is high time that we revamp our methods of teaching. ICT identifying a problem and finding solutions to things in the minimum possible time by generation of ideas, both in terms of quality and quantity. Technology as a medium serves greater purpose by providing a platform for idea simulation. It provides wider availability and application, which aid in interactive learning, and teachers can assist the students to emerge out stronger. In the contemporary changing world, there is a need to build a body of knowledge that is rooted in and caters to the needs of our nation. Innovative methods in education only has the right potential to create the required concepts and theories. So let us welcome our resource person for today's session. She is an excellent administrator and an effective pedagogue, Mrs. Renuka, currently the principal of Creative Multimedia College of Fine Arts, Tirchitnagar. With a corporate experience, she took a leap into teaching with a commendable experience of 10 years. She has a brilliant academic record and has received awards for her academic excellence. She has authored many books on information technology, programming languages, and e-commerce, facilitating the undergraduate students. She is also a member of Computer Society of India and International Association of Academic Class Corporate Society. Mrs. Renuka also has many papers and publications for her credit. She has been laureled with ILDC AMT Women Excellence Award 2019 in the field of academics. A very delightful welcome to you, ma'am. I now request Mrs. Renuka to take over the proceedings. Before we begin the session, I request all our dear participants to disable their videos and mute themselves. This will enable us to conserve the bandwidth and facilitate a smooth session. If you have any queries, please drop your questions in the live chat. Your questions will be addressed by the speaker after the session ends. Thank you. It's over to you, ma'am.
A very good morning to all the participants. I'm very thankful to the management of Villa Mary Degree College for Women for providing me such a wonderful opportunity. A big thanks to Mrs. Revati Devi Mathur, in charge Villa Mary Degree College, and Mrs. Gayatri, head of the department Computer Science and IQSC Villa Mary Degree College. As we all are aware of the crisis situation in the education field, where all the schools and colleges have been shut down due to COVID-19. So it was expected that this shutdown would impact the learning process to a great extent, but that was not the case. All thanks to technology. In this digital era where we are facing the barrier of social distancing, ICT has reduced this and became a new friend to all our teaching fraternity. So let us begin our webinar. So before starting the webinar, I would like to ask the participants a simple question. Are the terms IT, information technology, and ICT same? So you can answer this question in the chat box, whether you agree with the statement or disagree with the statement. So we can see some of them are agreeing to this and some of them are disagreeing with the statement. Okay, we have a mixed response from the audience. So let us find the answer for this question. So daily we are hearing these words IT and ICT. So IT stands for information technology, and it is like a general term where it is like a general term, and it covers the entire industry which uses computers, networking, and software. So it is all about managing the information, like how the information is collected, how the information is processed, and how it is shared over the network. Whereas when it comes to ICT, ICT stands for information, communication, and technology. It is just like an extensional term of IT. And it is mostly used in the field of communication, and here communication is given more emphasis. For example, like nowadays all of us are taking classes online, so we are using so many video conferencing platforms like Zoom, GoToMeeting, or GoToWebinar, or Microsoft Teams, or Google Meet. So many video conferencing softwares are there. So when you are using those video conferencing softwares and you are taking the classes, that means what? You are communicating the information which is stored in your brain or which is stored in your computer.
This conference will now be recorded.
Unmute yourself.
Hello. A very good morning to all the participants. So these kind of things will happen when we are using the technologies. So no worries, we'll start with the session. Okay, so we were discussing about the differences between IT and ICT, right? Like I have discussed, what is IT? IT stands for information technology, and it deals with the entire industry where it uses computers, networks, and softwares to deal with information. Here, information is given more emphasis, whereas in ICT, communication is given more emphasis, means how we are communicating. So apart from IT, we will have some more technology. That is, you will have various video conferencing softwares and broadcasting technologies, audio video processing and transmission. All these things are there in the ICT, and ICT is widely used in the field of education. Apart from education, it is also used in other industries as well. So let us start with another simple question, and this question, you can read it. Can all the subjects be taught online? So I request the audience to kindly post your answers, whether you agree with the statement or disagree with the statement. Like, there is a misconception that STEM subjects like science, technology, engineering, and medical subjects or some subjects cannot be taught online. There is a strong statement by some people. Okay, so I am getting a mixed responses. Some people are agreeing, some people are disagreeing with the statement. Okay, now I will not give the answer for this question right now. Let us continue with the webinar. At the end of the webinar, we will be able to give the answer to this question. So let us dive into the world of ICT tools.
Online whiteboards. So in this webinar, online whiteboards.
In this webinar, we are going to cover some of the ICT tools which will...
More than teaching, this is enough, no, Dolly, what we know. Right, screen.
Herself, okay. So, we will have
screen
so many...
casting tools.
...tools which will be dealing in this session. Like, what are the various whiteboard tools available? What are the various screen capture tools and screencasting tools, and how to assess our students online, and what are the different file conversion tools which will make our work easy. So let us continue with the first one, that is online whiteboard tools. So as a teacher, we all know what is the relationship between a teacher and a blackboard. So without blackboard, like we can't take the class on. So here on online, we will have many wonderful whiteboard tools which are available, and there are many wonderful whiteboard tools which are available, but in this webinar I would like to cover four whiteboards. The first one is a web whiteboard and classroom screen, class flow, and whiteboard.fi. So let us start with the first whiteboard, that is a web whiteboard. So as you know that this is a simple whiteboard, and here it is a touch friendly whiteboard, and it requires no registration. Like, it comes in two basic versions. That is, the first one is a basic version, which is a free version. For this, there is no requirement for registration. But the only problem is you cannot save the whiteboards. Automatically, everything disappears. Means if you are not doing any activity on the whiteboard for 2 hours, automatically it will disappear. And there is a premium version. Obviously, it is a paid version. So we will have a quick demo of this one, whiteboard tool. So when you click the website awwapp.com, you will get this website. And as you know, as I just told you, that it does not require any login or sign in. And it is a touch-friendly whiteboard tool. Touch-friendly means what? Here you can use your stylus pen and directly write it on the screen. But the screen should be a touch-sensitive screen. Then only the touch-friendliness will work. Otherwise, you can use your mouse clearly. So when I click that start drawing, I can immediately use this whiteboard and draw all the things. And here I have so many options. So I offer all the ICT tools. I will be covering some of the features. Due to time constraint, we will not be able to explore all the features of all the tools. So let us continue with this one. We have a pen here. So with this pen, you can write anything, and you have a marker also, and you can increase the width of the pen, and you can change the color of the pen here, whatever color you want.
You are muted only.
You can change it. And this is about this one, and you can have arrow marks, line arrow marks, or banded arrow marks here. You can use it in any way, and you can have a line also. And the next part is you have erasers. There are different types of eraser. First one is this eraser, you have to do it individually. This is like somewhat difficult for us. So what we can do is we can select the other thing, we can directly click on that particular element, the complete part element will be disappeared. Or you have another called scissor, you can mark it, that particular part which is marked by the scissor gets erased. So in this way you can use it. And here you can use two shapes, that is a rectangle, a filled rectangle, and an ellipse also you can use it. So you can take it, we have selected the color blue, so it is coming in blue color. And if you don't want to draw it, you want to type something, you can do it as well. Okay, you can type like this, and you can have a post-it notes also. That means you can display some instructions to your students if you want it. You can duplicate this one. You can keep the lesson name or anything which you want to, which you would like to share with your students. You can do it using the post-it notes. As I told you, this whiteboard is temporary. Why? Because we have not signed in. It is a basic version, so we cannot export this whiteboard. The only thing is you can export it into a image. That's it. Only the you can export this complete whiteboard into a image. We cannot do the PDF and PPT. Why? Because it is a basic version. So this is about the online whiteboard which is there. Now we will check the next one, that is classroomscreen.com. okay, this classroom screen is not only a web whiteboard, but it is something extra than that. Why? Because you can clearly display all the instructions for your students in a clear and visual manner. And it has so many widgets. Widget means what? These are supportive tools which will help your audience, which will help your students to work better, and you can engage them in a better way and an interesting way. So you have so many widgets. So we'll have a look at this. So when I click classroomscreen.com, you will get this screen. And like how you have the web whiteboard tool, this is also, you need not register for this one. You can quickly launch a new classroom screen, which is very easy for us. So when I click that, I will get a screen. Okay, so you can see the screen. This is somewhat appealing for the users also, right? Here, as I told you, these are the widgets which are available here. Down you can see so many widgets, right? These are the supportive tools. Like first one is what? Background. If you want to change the background, you can do it as well. You have so many backgrounds. Or if you don't want, you want to go with the plain one, you can select a plain background screen. Okay, and next is we will see a draw option here. See, draw means you will get a separate drawing panel. Okay, when I click this, I will get the basic thing like the eraser, like you have anything, you can write it over here. Okay, you have the thickness here, you can select the thickness here. If you don't want, you can just close the symbol, or if you want to increase the whiteboard, you can increase as well. So just we will keep it aside. Okay, now we will go to the next one, that is text box. So text, as you know, that we can have any text, we can type it. And the special part over here is you can check the font size, You can change the font type also. You can make it bold, italic, underlined. You can strike off the things. You can have subscript, superscript. Like for example, I want to type H2O. Okay, then I can do it like this also. You can use the subscript and superscript. You can also embed a link also. If you have any hyperlink which you want to show it to your students, you can easily do that. And you can do the alignments also. And as you know, this you can increase it or decrease it. Okay, you have so many options over here. And next you can have a clock. And the clock can be set to 12-hour format or 24-hour format according to your wish. Okay, you can have a clock, you can have even a calendar. Okay, if you want to assign any due dates to the students, or if you want to assign anything to the students, you can clearly show them the calendar, and that will be more appealing to the students. So next one is, we'll see this one, random name. So random name is, as we know that this is like a, I told you this is a free account. We have not logged in here. So when you log in with a free account, this classroom screen will provide you with an option that you can save three lists of your students' names. Suppose you are taking three classes. You can save all the names of the students in three different lists with a free account. So for just now, we will try to create some names. Okay, just typing some names randomly over here. Okay, and if I suppose these are the students who are present in my classroom. Now I want to choose one name, it will automatically choose. See, now I can see this way of doing the things will engage the students. They will be sticking on to the screen. They won't look into their WhatsApp or look into the other things while the class is going on. Means everything is on the screen. They have to be alert all the time. So if you want, you can again choose a different name. It will be coming. So for example, I want to ask a question to Purnima. I can just choose it. The name, whatever comes on the screen, I will ask a question to that particular student. Right. So this is the way you can do it. I'll just reduce it. And here you have so many other options, like dice is there. You can throw the dice, and these are all used for some kind of activities, right? Here you have a traffic light also. This can also be used for any activity which you want to have. And the specialty over here is you have a QR code for your classroom. That means students need not type all the things. Nowadays students are very lazy. They don't want to type so much things. So just they can grab their mobile and go to this QR code, and they can scan the QR code and they can easily enter your classroom, right? So here you have a stop timer and a stopwatch also. Okay, so suppose you are asking any question randomly to a student and you want to give them a time, so you can always do that. Here you can have stopwatch as well. Okay, so these are the things which are there. I'm just closing some of the thing, and I will show you one more option which is available here. That is work symbols. Work symbols are nothing but, suppose you have given some work to the student. Suppose the work has to be done alone, then you can use the symbol that you have to be silent and you have to do it. Or for example, you want a group work to be given to the students. So then you can use these symbols, which will be more appealing to the students, and you can engage the students in an interesting way. So these are the widgets which are available in the classroomscreen.com. So I hope this is a wonderful feature. Right. Next, we will be going to the next tool, next whiteboard tool, that is classflow.com. Now, classflow.com is something very special. Why? Because here it is not only a whiteboard. Here you can create your lessons, you can ask quizzes, you can conduct activities with the students, and you can quickly assess your student. And you have other feature called marketplace, which I will be telling you. And all these are cloud-based storage. That means what? All your information, whatever quizzes or lessons you have made. Everything is stored online and you can access it from anywhere. Right? Just we'll have a look into that. Classflow.com. If you type, you will be getting the screen like this. Okay. And you have different languages also over here. Okay. For this, we have to log in. For the previous two whiteboards, which we have discussed, that doesn't require any sign in or login. But here it requires login. And here, while logging in, it will ask us to log in with either as a teacher or as a student. Just a second, it is getting loaded. So classflow.com is something special.
Okay.
Just a second. Okay, so I'm just logging in. It is getting loaded. So Classflow is like a cloud-based storage, as I told you. So here we will have many other options. Just a second, there is a net problem. It came. So here, as I told you, it will ask you to log in as a teacher or as a student. Okay, so presently I'm logging in as a teacher. Okay, and I am checking my signing with my Google account. Okay, it is getting loaded. Right, so you can see the screen is getting loaded. And here we have so many options here. Like I told you, it is not only a whiteboard, but something more than that also, right? So here you can have an instant whiteboard. Okay, here you can have an instant whiteboard, or you can go with a quick poll to your students. Like, see, for example, this quick whiteboard is getting loaded. Okay, so already I have created some over here. If you want, you can have all the things here. You have text, you can add the shapes, you can have the pen eraser, like commonly what will be available in a normal whiteboard, pen, marker, you can insert the shapes, all those things will be available here. You can use all those things and make it here. And this code which you are seeing here, this code you have to give it to your students, and the students have to log in as a student. Just now we have logged in as a teacher, so there you have another option also, log in as a student. So your student has to log in as a student and they have to click this code, then they will be connecting to your whiteboard, right? So next is, we can easily create a lesson also. Okay, just we'll have a look at that. We can easily create a lesson. So here you have all the options. You can select, you can have shapes, you can have text, you can have so many things. You can just type whatever things are there and you can have all your lessons planned here. And here, if you see, these are like cards. Cards are nothing but the pages of your classes, right? And here you have math formulae also. You can use this well for your max classes also. There are so many options. You can insert a picture, you can take a camera capture also, you can do many things, right? So next we will be going to the next thing, that is, we can have a quick quiz or assessment also. We can do the internal assessment or anything, we can do it over here. Just we have to click the multiple choice or what type of questions you want to ask. You can have many different types of questions are there, not only multiple choice. You can ask them a short answer, it can be a fill in the blank, it can be a match list, anything, the choice is up to you. So after adding one question, you can add one more question also. Even insert, you can insert pictures into this, right? So we'll have a next thing. We can have activities as well. As I told you, we can have activities. It is not only a whiteboard, but something more than that, right? So here you have many activities which are there. Like you can have categorize, you can have crossword, flash game, memory game, word search, so many things are there, right? So you can select any activity and do that, right? So next, coming to the next option, you can create a quick poll to your student, whether just now I asked you some question, right? So you can ask some random questions to the students and they can quickly give the answers. Now, for example, here, I am going to my resources, which I have already created. For example, I am checking this activity. See, this is an activity which I have created already, that is matching activity. And we will see here buttons are there, you can play. For example, if I click on play, just a second. It is getting loaded. Okay, matching activity. It is getting loaded. So we'll see. You can have many types of activities. Like, see, for example, let's play this one. So I have already created this. If I try to match these things, for example, if I suppose, see, it is coming as wrong. So I can quickly drag and drop all these things. And after that, I have finished. So this is how you can play any games. Or you can ask your students to do the things. And the best part of this is you have already ready-made lessons are available. So you can just select the type of subject which you want and the type of file also, whether you want it as a lesson, whether you want it as an assessment or how you want it, activities, all so many already ready-made activities, ready-made lessons are there, which you can just take it and upload it as your resource, and you can edit them also. So this is like a wonderful tool for all the teachers, right? So next, we will have a look at another option, another whiteboard tool, that is whiteboard.fi. So here, as we have seen that this whiteboard tool is also like what we have seen in the starting, like web whiteboard or classroom screen, that no registration or login is required. And the best part is you can save these whiteboards to PDF so that you can refer it again. Okay, and you can insert images. And the specialty of this one is you can insert mathematical expressions also. And it gives privacy control and access control. We just will have a look at this whiteboard. See here, as I told you, it doesn't require any login. So if you are a teacher and if you want to do the whiteboard thing, then you have to click on new class. Suppose if you are a student, then you have to click on the join class. Suppose now I am clicking on new class. So I'm just typing the class name. Okay, and I am creating my class. Here there are so many settings. Here you have two tabs. If you observe, one is my class and the other one is my whiteboard. So my whiteboard is the whiteboard of the teacher. That means I have created this classroom. So this is the whiteboard of mine. And this my class is there. This is the whiteboard of the students. Now there are no students waiting here, right? So that's why this is empty. Once if I send this code, this room code is there. If I send this link or this code to the students, they can easily log in to my whiteboard and I can see all their whiteboards in this place, right? Okay, so in this way, you can see what your students are doing also, whether all of them are doing the work or not, whether they are giving responses to your questions or not, you can easily check it, right? So as a simple whiteboard, all it contains a free drawing mode, eraser, drawing, you can have a text also. Okay, so many things you can have it. You can have so many shapes, insert an image, insert a background image, everything. So the best part is here, if you go into actions, if you want, if you're ready with your whiteboard, then you can push this whiteboard to all students so that your whiteboard is appearing to all the students. Otherwise, suppose here you have another option called as insert. Insert, you have, you can insert tables as well as you can insert any mathematical expression. Suppose, for example, here you can type whatever mathematical expression you want, or you can use the LaTeX code also. You can use this and insert math. If you click C, you get the mathematical expression on the screen. So you can easily use for your mathematical subjects, the subjects where equations are required. You can use this as well. And after doing everything, suppose you have so many settings here. Just now I told you in the access control, so many options are there. Like access control means what? You can lock the room. Suppose, for example, you have started your class and you don't want anyone after the prescribed time, you don't want your students to enter into your whiteboard tool. So you can just lock it, or you want to see who is waiting. You can see that also. There are so many options here. You can check the options and you can save the whiteboard if you want. You can save the whiteboard as well. So I'm just closing this. This is about the whiteboard.fi. So with this, we have covered most of the whiteboards which are available. Okay, then we will have one more tool which is very useful or for all the teachers, that is screen capture tools. What is screen capture? Screen capture is nothing but screenshot. Like means how to take a screenshot. All of us know how to take a screenshot on mobile. It's very easy, right? But we don't know how to take a screenshot on the laptop, or if you are using a desktop or PC, we don't know that. So how to take the screenshot on that, or how to capture your screen? So we will be seeing that. First, I will be using a simple thing, that is print screen button, which is already available on your keyboard. For example, just a second. For example, this is the website. I want to take this part, right? I want to take only this part, or I want to take this picture or anything. So how can I do that? After going to that particular page or that particular lesson, whatever you are, you just press the print screen button, which is already there on your keyboard. After pressing the print screen button, you just go to the paintbrush option will be there. You just go there. And after that, you just click on Control V or paste it. Simply paste it over there. You get the complete screen what you have captured just now. Suppose I want only a particular picture. I can select it. Okay. I can select it and I can cut it and paste it, and I can save it in my computer. This is how you can generate the screenshot. So this is one tool which can be used. Just I'm not going to save this, right? The other option which is there is snipping tool. Like most of you might be aware of this particular tool. It is a tool which is already available in the Microsoft Vista or later versions. It comes free with Windows operating system. So you can, it's like a utility tool, right? Now, how to start the snipping tool? You can find it. You can find snipping tool from all programs, accessories. In that snipping tool option is there, right? So we'll see how this works. Okay, I'm just going to the same website. Just a second. I'm going to the same website where I want to capture, and I am using the snipping tool. So the snipping tool is here. See, when I click the snipping tool, you get this small box kind of thing, tool tip here. You can select a new snip. Okay. Suppose, for example, I am clicking a new snip. See, for example, I can snip it like this. Okay, like just a second. See, here when I am selecting the new snip, if I want to have a rectangular snip, I can have a rectangular snip. That means I can take this one, or see, automatically when I click that, the rectangular snip is like whatever I have captured just now, that is called as a snip. That will come here. You can save it, or you can send it to an email as an email to all your students, but you should require a Microsoft Outlook account for that, right? Or otherwise you can just take a pen and suppose you want to highlight this one, okay? Or you want to, circle something, you want to show something to the students, because students won't be reading the complete text. If you highlight some things, then they can easily find out this. Suppose I want to highlight this one. So I will just select that particular thing and the students will be able to do the things, right? You can have erasers. Suppose I, by mistakenly, if I have done something, you can erase it as well. Okay. And if you want here, see this, the difference between print screen and the snipping tool is print screen, everything will be captured. The whole screen is captured and it is somewhat not that much compatible also. Here you have so many other options in snipping tool. You can have a window snip, you can have a full screen snip, you can have a free form. That means suppose I want to select only this part, that particular part will be coming. So it's up to you how you use the tool. Okay, so next we will be checking the next option. So these are about the screen capture tools, means how you have to take the capture, how you have to take the screenshot of your screen, right? So the next one is screencasting tool. Now what is screencasting? Screencasting is nothing but suppose you are telling something on the screen, you want to record everything what is happening on your screen and you want to make a video like that. So these tools will be very much helpful for you. And what are the best tools available for screencasting tools? These are the two tools which are available for the screencasting, that is Loom and Screencastify. So we'll have a look at these two tools which are available. Loom is a excellent screencasting tool, and it should not be mistaken, it is not similar to Zoom is a video conferencing software, whereas Loom is a screencasting software. And the best part of this is it captures very high quality screencasting, right? And it is available in Chrome extension, or a desktop app is also available. What is Chrome extension? Suppose you are using Google Chrome as your web browser, then you can download some extensions and you can directly use them, like I will be showing you now. And the best part is Loom Premier version or the professional version is completely free for all the teachers and students. After this lockdown, they have declared that it is completely free for all the teachers and students. That's a good news for all of us, right? And you have so many sharing and saving options. You can directly load your video to your YouTube if you have a YouTube channel, or you can save it to your Google Drive. Okay, and it comes with a Loom editor also. That means you can edit your videos once you have recorded. So we'll have a look at this one. See, if you see here on my, after my address bar, here you can see the extension. That means already I have loaded that extension. If you just type Loom, it will come the extension. If you get the extension, it will be directly uploaded here. So if I click this extension, I can immediately start with the capturing of my video or whatever it is there. So here, see, it gives three options for you. That means you can have a Okay. See, for as of now, my camera is being used by the GoToMeeting, so I cannot capture my camera. So if you see this round color circle is there, here your camera, that means live, whatever you are narrating, it will be coming over here. So Loom is a screencasting tool. That means it is best for the instructional videos where you can share your ideas in a clear way, right? So you have one option, that is screen plus camera. Your screen will also be recorded, as well as your photo. The camera part will also be recorded. Otherwise, you can have only screen only, or if you want, you don't want to show your screen to the audience, you can always go for the camera only. Okay, so you can start recording. So now I will record whatever is coming. So it gives a countdown. So whatever I am telling now, everything is recorded. If you see, it is telling Loom for Chrome is sharing your screen. So everything is getting recorded. So if I say stop sharing, then it automatically takes you to Loom editor part where you can edit your videos in an easy way. Suppose, for example, if I play this video, you can see whatever I have recorded, everything is getting in this video. And if you want to trim this video, you can do it. Suppose I don't want first few seconds of my video, I can directly do it. Okay, you can create a custom thumbnail if you want to upload it as a YouTube video, and you can invite this video, or you can send this video to all your students by copying this link, or you can invite people, or you can download the video as well for future reference. You can copy this one, or if you don't want, you can delete it, you can share. Many options are there. So this is excellent tool for screencasting. If you want to record a video and send it to your students, this is an excellent tool which is available, and it comes in a Chrome extension as well as a desktop app, right? So we'll have another tool which is there, that is Screencastify. Now Screencastify is also a Chrome extension. It is only a Chrome extension which comes free with Google Chrome, right? Like Loom, if you see, Loom has a desktop app also, but here Screencastify is having only Chrome extension. And the best part is it offers offline recording option also. That is best option. That means whenever there is no internet connection, you can record the video, and after that you can make it online to your students, right? And it also provides annotation tools, means when you are explaining something, you can mark it, you can highlight some things. So many options are available in this one. And as it is a Chrome extension, all your recordings will be auto-saved to your Google Drive. That means no need for you to download it or save it or things. Everything is automatically saved to your Google Drive. You can export it as an MP4, MP3, or anything. So many options are there. We'll have a look at this Screencastify also. See, when you click screencastify.com, it is coming because I have already installed this extension. If you see here, the logo, the arrow mark, it is already there. So if you observe, you can check. If you click this one, automatically your recording gets started. So if I click this one, see, here it is coming. If I click record, everything gets recorded. And here, as in Loom, you have web camera only, all options were there, right? All options are available here also. So this is about Screencastify. Okay, so we'll have at another ICT tool, and that is your assessment tool. Now, what is assessment and what is the importance of assessment? Assessment is the most important task, right? For example, assessment is an integral part of the teaching and learning process. Students can learn from their assessments. They can easily easily get motivated, and it also provides further scope of improvement. They can, after getting the assessment grades, they can easily assess themselves, and where they are lacking, they get just motivated and they will try to improve in further assessments. So assessment is very, very required, right? Next is our role, that means teacher's role in creating appropriate assessments is very, very essential nowadays. Why? Because just now we have seen so many exams have been cancelled and all the schools and colleges are giving the grades. So I think that a single exam at the end of the year or semester is not enough to judge the student's capacity, right? So we should have a more diversified assessment process, which requires, right? And for that, we have to have a continuous assessment rather than a summative assessment. We all know, we all are working in colleges, we know how the internal assessment goes on or how the final exams goes on. So we can't rely on such things as of now. And in future, we may have a different methods of assessments, right? So for that, what as a teacher we have to do, we have to create or we have to maintain a portfolio for each student and assess them continuously rather than putting a monthly test or at the end of the semester, you are going to judge them. That doesn't work right now in this situation, right? So we have to continuously evaluate our students. Right? How we are going to assess them and what are the different ways we can assess the students' learning online. Offline, we know we have so many methods. Like offline, online, what are the different methods we can use in student assessment? So I request all the participants, whatever methods you have in your mind, you can just type it in the chat box. What methods do you think which will help in the assessing student learning online? Offline, we all know, but how we can do these things online? So I want all the participants just give your answers. So we have so many options which are coming in the chat box, right? So many of them are giving many methods, right? Okay, good. There is so much response from the audience, right? Now these are some of the methods. Few methods I'm sky is the limit for creating the assessments, right? So some of the assessment tools or some of the assessment methods which you can use online are multiple choice questions. This is simple way. Open-ended questions, online assignments, or online discussion boards, open book system, e-learning blogs or essays, or you can have an oral exams or interviews also. So these are just a few methods I'm mentioning here. You can create, you can use all your creative skills and develop your kind of assessments, right? That is up to you. Now, what are the different assessment tools? Now we have seen methods, what all things we can do, but what are the tools we need to use to make all these assessments come in a real thing? Now we have so many things like Edpuzzle is there, Kahoot is there, Flipgrid and Neopod. All these are the various online assessment tools which are available to make your work easy. And these are not just simple assessment tools, but these assessment tools will engage your students in an interesting way, and you can assess them in a different way rather than using the traditional methods, right? So we will just have a look at the first assessment tool which is available online, that is Edpuzzle. Edpuzzle is, it can have your interactions, whatever questions you want to ask, you can immediately put in the videos. Already, suppose just now we have created a video, or in the future, in the past, you have created some videos. You want to add some questions in between those videos rather than just simply going through the video. If you have some questions incorporated in between the videos, that will engage the students in a better way, right? So you can do that using this very interesting tool called as Edpuzzle. And the best part is it is 100% free for all the teachers and students. And there are so many saving and sharing options. And even you can track the students' assessment, like what, like the best part is this one. You can have all the grades or whatever things the students have done. You can easily track what the students are doing with the analytics, which is available on this tool, right? So just we'll have a look at that. We'll click on this edpuzzle.com. The site is getting loaded. So you can see you have, you can log in. Now just getting started. So as you can see, it says stop boring classes in the track. Now I am logging in as a teacher. So I'm just logging in by with my Google account. Okay. It is getting loaded. Just a moment. Okay. So here the options are, you can have, you can record a video here also, or if you have something which is already recorded, you can take that as well, right? But here you have so many other options, like suppose you don't want to record any video, you want to take some video from the YouTube, or you have Khan Academy, which is an excellent open source library which is available of video lessons. So many lessons are there. Or you want to download any TED Talks and share it with your students. So you have so many options over here. You can directly take them and put it as your resource, right? Suppose, for example, here I have one lesson which I have already downloaded from the YouTube. So you can just check it. So this is a video which is already there in the YouTube. Or you can create your own video also. That is also there. Now, after selecting the thing, I am going here. Some options are there: assign, edit, duplicate, and delete. If I click on edit, see, the video gets started. Suppose if I click this one, the video is getting started.
We know that there are a lot of important parts inside a desktop computer, but what exactly do they do?
Suppose, for example, at this point of time, I would like to ask them a question. So for example, here I want to add a question at this point of time in the video. I can have a multiple choice question, or I can have an open-ended question also, right? So suppose, for example, I want to ask something like an open-ended question. What do you think of this video? Or some question. It can be any question which is related to that video. And here you have so many options. If you are seeing, you can have bold, italic, underline, subscript, superscript. You can even add a link. You can paste a image also, or you have, you can insert the so many mathematical symbols or special symbols are also available. You can add all these things on your video, right? Suppose everything is completed. You just want to save. You save it.
In this,
see, at this point I have added one question, so it is coming like this. So if this is assigned to your student, suppose for example I have finished my questions, so I will click on this finish button over here, and here assign option is there. If I click assign, this lesson or this video, I'm going to assign it to my students. So when the students are listening to the video or checking the video, they will get the question. So if you can see here, at 0.05 seconds, I have added one question. At 9 seconds, I have added one question. At 24 seconds, I have added one question. Like if you see here, okay? So here, in this way, you can engage your students rather than simply watching the video. They can engage or they can interact with the video, right? So if I assign, the video is getting assigned to my students, and whatever the students are typing for these questions which I have asked, everything will be stored. Why? Because they will be logging with the student login. So everything is recorded, and all those things you can easily check it or you can easily manage it, right? So this is about Edpuzzle. Everything is recorded here. You can have your content. As of now, I have not assigned this lesson to any student, right? That's why I am not getting that analytics. If you have assigned it, you will be getting that part as well, right? So this is about Edpuzzle. Next is Kahoot. Kahoot, this you might have listened so many times in so many webinars also. It is like a game-based learning platform. Game-based learning platform, because today's students, they want to play games. So if you can incorporate games into your lessons, then the students will be more engaging. So here you can create self-paced games. That means according to the student level of the students, you can create different types of students, and you can even allow them to work collaboratively. You can give a group work, like one game or one question or one assignment, you can give it to a group of students and they can collaboratively work. Then that is like a wonderful feature of Kahoot. And again, it is also free for teachers and students. That is a good part. This COVID has given teachers and students the best thing, that many of the tools are becoming free for us, right? That means learning should not be stopped at any point of time. COVID or any other virus cannot stop the learning process or the teaching process, right? So here we'll have a look at Kahoot. So if I click here, you are seeing so many options are there here. Now I'll just log in. I have already created one account for this. So I'm just logging in. I'm just logging in with my Google account. Okay. I'm just logging in with my Google account. And it is getting loaded, right? So you can create many Kahoots like this. Kahoot means what? It's like an assessment or assignment, right? So if you observe here, so many are there. You can host a Kahoot, or see, this is again, you have two options here, basic version and the premium version here. So here, if you want create, just click on the button create. You will be right creating many, already some templates are there. Okay, you can use already designed templates, or you can create your own thing. So you can type the question, and as well in other parts which we have seen here, you have bold, italic option, superscript, subscript, and you have different mathematical symbols or currency symbols are there, Greek symbols, so many other symbols are also there. You need not worry about how to type a question which includes a equation or any other symbols. So you can type your question, you can select the points for that particular question, right? You can select the time limit for that question also. That is the best part. You can select the time limit also, because you know, so many people will be taking more time or searching it on the Google and pasting their answers. If you want to remove that part, then you can have this option called as time limit. You can put the time limit, you can put an image, everything, YouTube link also you can put it, and you can add your answers here. Or if you already have a question bank, that means already you have stored so many questions and you want to randomly select from that particular question bank, you can even do that here. Or if you want to import any slides, you can import slides as well as Excel files also you can import here. So this is about Kahoot. It is just one example of Kahoot. You can create many such Kahoots. It's not only a multiple choice question. You can create many different types of questions. Here you have discover. If you select this one, you will see already created Kahoots by many of the teachers like us, and it is so many are there. You can see the collection. It is like there is no limit for the collection. And here you can see lessons, or you can select the activities. You can select anything. You can select anything and create your own thing also, right? So you have so many things like this. So this is about Kahoot, right? Next, we'll see one more interesting assessment tool which is available online, that is Flipgrid. Now, Flipgrid is like a video discussion platform. Rather than answering the questions or playing the games, here your students can submit video assignments. Now, why video assignments? Because if you give any assignments, they will copy paste from the Google and submit it to you, or they can do any, they can use any other methods, right? But here, if you ask them to take a video assignment of your question or of your discussion, then that improvises their creativity also. Then it improves their self-confidence also, because they have, in future, they have to face so many interviews, right? So this works well for that also. That means you are, it's like a seminar. We cannot have a seminar, right? So here, if we, through videos, they will be able to learn. And again, Flipgrid was initially taken by a different company, but after Microsoft has taken this Flipgrid, it made free for all the educators. That means it is free for us, right? So here, if you click on the flipgrid.com, you can have this website which is coming over here, and you can sign it. See, educator sign up, it's free, right? Suppose if you are a student, then you have to enter some code. Now, what is that code? I will be telling you right now. So this is how some grids already I have created here, just to show you all the things. And now, what is grid? Grid is like a classroom. Okay, grid is like a classroom. You can connect anything. Suppose, for example, you want to add a new grid, you can add it. You can tell the class name. You can always see, you here you have email option also, which you can use it for the students. Suppose you have their email IDs, you can just type their email IDs. Or if you have student IDs, like for example, we'll be having roll numbers, right? So if you want that also, we can ask them to join through that. Or you can share it, this grid, whatever you are creating, to the community, so that other people, other educators like you, can be able to see your grid. So you're sharing it in a public way. And here you have this flip code. Suppose if you are satisfied with this one, you can have it, or otherwise you can delete it and you can type your own grid, your own code for this one. So this code, you have to give it to the students. Just now we have seen educators pre-sign up and other one flip code one option was there. So there, suppose you are giving this code to a student, then student has to log in with this code in order to see your grid. So this is about that. And for example, okay, just a second. I'll check with a lesson. Okay, I'm creating a lesson called IT, and I'm sharing with the email. I'm checking this one. So here I can type any email. I'm just typing a email for the demo purpose. Okay, then see, you're ready to do this, and you can share this link to Microsoft Teams, because this Flipgrid is owned by Microsoft. You can do that, or you can share it to your Google Classroom, or you can share it on a reminder also. Okay, or you can embed this code also, right? So now we'll go to our grid. Now, for example, here you can add, if you want to edit this grid, you can edit as well. Or if you want to add co-pilots, co-pilots means what? Suppose you want to share this information with any other teacher as well. So you can add that person as a co-pilot also, right? So this is about, so here I want to add a discussion board. For example, here I want to ask, what do you think of present Indian, just a second, it's a limit, present Indian economy, suppose, for example, or situation, something like that. You can ask them to type their recording, and you can set the recording timing also. You can ask them for 15 seconds or even for 10 minutes also. And here you have so many other options. So in this way, you have to create a topic and send this topic to the students, so that students will be getting all their topics or video assignments, and they will be sending it to you, and all those things will be recorded. So there is no need for you to again documentation everything. It is very useful. Now, online assessment tools, that is the best part. That means you need not record anywhere. Everything is recorded already. So it is very much useful for on documentation also. So this is about Flipgrid, right? Next is, we will see what is a Nearpod. Now, Nearpod is another student engagement platform, which again, you can create presentations, like you can create any PPTs over here, and that PPTs will also have, not like simple slides which are running, you can have quizzes in that, polls, videos, drawing boards. Students can even draw on the PPTs also. Many things are there in this Nearpod. You can ask open-ended questions, which includes various mathematical symbols as well. So just we'll have a look at this. When you click nearpod.com, you will be getting a screen, right? So here is the screen which is there. I have already logged in, and the best part of Nearpod is the silver user. It means whenever an educator logs in, the silver user is free. It means you are eligible for all the features which are available for a silver user, right? So here you have three options over here. First is, you can have a discussion. Suppose you want to discuss a topic with the students, you want to know their opinions, you can immediately do that over here. Or you want to have a quiz, you can do it over here. And this is the activities part. Now you can create a lessons. Just now I told you, we can create presentations. Or if you have already a lesson which is stored in your Google Slides, you can get it over here, right? And you can get all the reports also. Just now I told you, everything has been documented. Means whatever you are doing or whatever your students are doing, automatically everything gets documented over here, and you can check in your reports. Or for example, we'll see with the discussion board. So we'll have a new discussion here. So just a second. So this is a code with which the students can log in. You can send it as an email or share it via WhatsApp. So many options are there, right? So here, see, for example, already I have shown one question to the students. They can see, when the students have logged in with the code which is there, just now I have sent one code to the students. With that, if they have logged in, then they will be seeing the question on the screen, and they can type their answers over here. Or if they want to have pictures related to that also, they can answer it here. Means the students can use their creativity to the next level, and they can easily answer the question, right? So you can also hide the student's name. That means as this is visible to all the students, if you don't want who has submitted already, then you can have this option like hide student. All these options are available, and this is a code for our Nearpod classroom, right? So this is about Nearpod. And as in other assessment tools, like already ready-made things are available, right? So here also you have Nearpod lesson library is there. So many lessons are already created by the educators like us. So you can have, you can select anything from that and add it as your resource. And on the topic, you can create any game, anything you can do, right? So this is about Nearpod. So this is so these are the various tools. These are the various online assessment tools which are available. Right? So we are going to discuss about file conversion. So what are file conversion? Some kind of disturbance from the audience. Kindly mute yourself. Please, it's a request. Right. So we have so many file conversion tools. Now, what are file conversion tools? Like, for example, we have some PDF. We want to convert it. Or we have some PPT. We want to convert it. So how to do all those things that I will be telling you. The first part which I want to tell you is how to convert our handwritten notes to Google Documents. Or you can later download it as a Word document also. Now, as we all know, till now, everyone was using books, paper and pen for writing, all those things. Suppose many of us might be having the notes which we have studied in our college life also, that we are going to refer to invite our students or to tell our students. So how to convert that handwritten notes to Google Docs? Why? Because now if you want to type all those notes, it will be very, very difficult for us. So in order to avoid that, how we have to convert that notes, we will be showing. We'll be seeing. So for example, I will be showing you that. Just a second. For that, what you need to do is, whatever notes is there, you just take a screenshot. That means you take a picture of that particular page or whatever thing is there. You take a picture and upload it to your Google Drive. That is the first step you have to do. You have to take a picture, then you have to upload it to the Google Drive. And here, for example, I am taking, these are the pictures which I have already loaded. So what I will do, suppose this one I want to convert it. What I will do, I will right click this particular file which you want to edit, then click on open with Google Docs. Open with Google Docs. So if you see the file which is there, which is a handwritten one, is getting converted. Now I will be showing you how that conversion process happens. Right? So this is a English handwritten one. Okay, if you see the picture, whatever it is there, that will come over here and the converted text will come down. It is taking time, just a second. See, this is the handwritten one and it is getting converted. But here one simple problem will be there here. What is that? Our handwriting should be legible. It should be clear. Otherwise, because computer, right, it's also a machine. It cannot understand, right? We can understand all the students' writing. They can even write in doctor's handwriting, but we can understand that. System, it cannot understand, right? So here, if you see, it is there, the, but the is not written clearly. That's why I have taken this document. It is coming as, instead of THE, it is coming as DITHE. That means what? The handwriting should be clear. Then it works absolutely fine. See, everything is coming over here. So you do the simple editing of this one, then your document is ready. See, not only English document, you can even have, just a second, see, I can even have a Hindi written document. Just the same process, select the picture, go to open with, select Google Docs, open with Google Docs. Similarly, I will do a Telugu handwritten document also. Okay, I'll show you. Just a second, huh? See, the Hindi document, which is handwritten one, it is also getting converted into your Google Docs. So here, if you see, it will give spelling suggestions also. Just a second, see. It is exactly coming. So if you see here, it is giving spelling mistakes also. If you want to correct the spellings also, it will give. It will give you the suggestions, like for how English words will come. The same way we can get the spelling suggestions for this also. This is how you can convert any Hindi document also. Similarly, Telugu also, see. You can select any Telugu document also and do it. So this is about the first file conversion tool which is available, right? Next is... Next
can
is...
I interrupt?
Yes, ma'am.
Sorry to disturb the flow. Ma'am, when you said that we can convert into Google Doc, like you said picture and then the conversion will be there beneath the picture. So yes. Will that picture still remain if you want to share the, can we remove
that? You can remove that, ma'am. You can remove that.
Ma'am, one more thing, like if I want to include a watermark with my name in the Google Doc, can I do that here?
Definitely. See, whatever formatting or editing you want to do, you can do it. All the things you can do. Just to have shown the conversion, ma'am. Just okay. Formatting, editing, you can do it. You can remove the picture.
Thank okay, thank you so much, ma'am. Okay.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. So, the next PDF thing is PDF conversion tools. Now, this is a major problem with all of us because we are getting so many PDF files or so many documents, Word documents will be there or so many PPTs will be there which we want to share it with the students. And whenever you share any document with anyone on online or with your students, better we have to send it as a PDF. Why PDF? Because it is portable document format. That means anyone can read it. Why? Because suppose you are sharing a Word file to your students through WhatsApp, then they may not be able to read that Word document. Why? Because Word will not be available in their phone, or you are sending an Excel file, they may not be able to read it. So the best part is you have to convert the document into your PDF and you have to send it to the students, right? Or any other person also. It's the best protocol which we have to follow so that any deviations will not be happening. Like what you have typed, you cannot, the other persons cannot erase it, or so many things are there, right? So how to convert that one means there are so many tools again for this conversion also. Like when you download any Acrobat reader, or so many PDF readers are there now. So many are there. So if you want to do that, so many are there, but I suggest, or which I use mostly, is this website called as ilovepdf.com, which gives you so many options. Like for example, if you have an Excel document, it will be converted to a PDF easily. And if you have a Word to PDF, Word to PPT, PDF to Word, so many options are there. Just you use them for your demo purpose. I am showing you one thing. Suppose, for example, you want to merge. For example, you have three lessons, three PDFs are there. You want all combinedly merge into a single PDF, and that PDF you want to share it with your students. You can do it well with this one. For that, I will be clicking on Merge PDF option. And just select the PDF files, whatever are there. Okay, I'm just selecting the PDFs For example, here I have created three files. I'm selecting all the three lessons and I am clicking on open. Now see, the lessons will be shown here. If you feel that I don't want to include this file, you can remove it. But now I want to include all the three lessons in my folder. So what I will do, I will select the things and I will click on merge PDF. So PDFs have been merged. If you want, you can download that. Or see, so all the things will be merged into a single file and everything is opened. See, all the files have been merged. This is how you do a, just a second, let me close these tabs. Huh. This is how you have to merge. Now the other option is you can split PDF also. Like for example, when you are referring to any topic, we will be referring to so many textbooks and so many references books will be there. So we and the students will not be able to read all the reference books or all the textbooks. Suppose for example, one topic is good in one textbook. You select that part and one more topic is very well demonstrated or well written in another textbook or reference book. You can select from that and you want to select a particular file or a particular pages range from a particular PDF file, you can do with this excellent option called as split PDF file. Now I will show you a demo. Select PDF file. You just select, for example, I'm selecting lesson number 3 and click on open. Now if you see how many pages are there in this one, it is from 1 to 20, but I don't want to send all the 20 pages to my students. I want only a particular page or range of pages for my students. So here you have two options called split by range. That means you want from page number 1 to 5. You can select that. See, it will show. Or if you want only a single file, see, here I have extract all pages. Now, how many pages are there? 20 pages. Now I will be selecting only, suppose I want to only this page. I will select only page number 20 and split file. The split file has been, we have to download it, right? So it asks you the save location. You save it and you open it. See, only that particular page has been converted into a PDF file. So in this way, you can send only the things which you want to share it with your student from any reference textbook or any textbook if you want to do it, right? So this is about I Love PDF website, which is there, and so many other. You can compress the PDF, you can remove, repair it, you can edit it, so many other. But due to time limit, I may not be covering all these things. So I have shown only two options, that is merge and split PDF, right? So moving on to our next topic. Okay, these were the file conversion tools which we have done. Now coming to the bonus tip, right? So these are the tools which I find it I cannot include in any of those categories. So I have added in the bonus tools. The first option is insert learning. This is an excellent option which I thought to share with all of you. That, see, just a second, first, for example, this is a web page or this is a lesson which you want to share it with your student. So simply what you will do, you can give this website link to the students, they can read it. That is not the option here. But insert learning is something extra than that. For example, when you click on insert learning, you will get in the Google, if you type insert learning, if you you will be getting this page. So here it is also a Chrome extension. Extension means, just now we have seen Loom, Screencastify, how they are Chrome extensions. In the same way, the Insert Learning is also a Chrome extension and it is free with the Chrome browser. But if you use any other browser, it may not work. If you have Google Chrome web browser, then only it is going to work. So add to Chrome, already I have inserted that. See, if you see here, the purple color one IL is written. So you have this Chrome extension here. Now, this is the web page which I want to share with my students. So what I will do, I will just click on the insert learning extension which is available here. Okay, I will just select that. Now it is getting loaded. You can see the options for insert learning here. What is that? Here, if you have, suppose I want to highlight. See, web page means you will have so much of information. I don't want my students to read all the information, but to highlight some important things. What I will do? I will simply click on the highlighting things. That means what? My students will be highlighting, will be reading only those parts. You can do that as well. Or if you want, you can have a sticky notes. For example, here. See, here you can write anything like instructions or something, or working of IoT. This website, this web page is regarding IoT. So if you want to do like that, okay, you can have a sticky notes. Or if you want to take a video also, you can take it over here. And suppose, for example, here you have scenario one, IoT in your home. Suppose I want to have a discussion on this particular topic with my students. So how to have that? You click on this and click on this paragraph. Here you will be having a discussion topic. For example, I want to ask them what are the other examples you can give. Means for this particular scenario, what are the other examples they can give? Okay, you just create it. See, all the responses from my students, I can see it here. Okay, when can I see it here? When I assign this particular web page to my students, I can do it. I can see the responses from my students. I can even share this particular web page with other teachers as well. Suppose one subject is taken by two or three teachers, then we can easily share with them. We can edit the lesson info. You can print this lesson. All these options are there. You can go to the dashboard. Dashboard means here you can see all the responses which are coming from the students. Everything is recorded there, right? Or you can have a not only a discussion, you can have a question also. You can create any question, not only an open-ended question. Here it will give. See, here it will give you the types of question also. Suppose you want to summarize the above text. What do you mean by this text? The thing will be there here, right? So these are, see, if I type this, the responses will be coming from my students, right? So here, in this way, you can insert anything like this. You can highlight the text. Okay, or you can even comment on the text. For example, see, these are the options which are available. You can insert a sticky notes, you can insert a question, you can even insert a discussion. You have so many options like assigning, all these options are there. So this is about insert learning, right? So the next option or the next tool which we are going to discuss is Desmos. Desmos. So this Desmos is nothing but, just a second. So Desmos is like a graphing tool, graphing calculator. For example, you want to show some calculator, some graphs to your students. So you can easily do it. And this also, again, you need not log in. You can directly simply click on this graphing calculator. The graph will be uploaded. Here you can type any mathematical expression. See, it will give the graph related to this particular mathematical expression. Suppose you want to find out the t distribution for 5 degrees. So it will be giving you the distribution curve for this one. Not only that, you can even use your statistical functions also. Like for example, I want to find out the mean. So you can see the mean of these things, 1 to 5 is 3. You are getting like this. So you can use all the statistical tools, statistical distributions or graphs, mathematical. You want to plan a parabola or anything, you can do it. Suppose for example, I am typing another thing, y is equal to mx plus c. Now here m and c are what? Constant. So here I can add a slicer. Slicer means what? Suppose now my c value is here. I want to change the c value. Now if my c value is -4.9, what will be the curve it will be showing? So here you can increase or decrease the values of c or m, and the graph automatically changes according to the settings which you have done. And here you can add the expression, even you can export whatever it is already there in your Excel file. Excel file, you will have so many things. So that Excel table also, you can just download it here. So many options are there. Just have a look at this one. Okay, you can delete all the things. If you want to save this, you can save it. You want to take a screenshot, you can take a screenshot. So many options are there in this Desmos graphing tool. So this is an excellent tool for all the statistics and mathematical lecturers over there. Now I'm just leaving this website. Now one more small tip for teaching accounts subject. So you can open any like Google Documents, or you can type any Word also. You can do it in Word, but now as of now I'm doing it in a Google Documents. You can do it in a Google Doc, Word, PDF or anything. I'm selecting a blank document. Okay, suppose you want to show a balance sheet or so many other things will be there. I'm not having an exact idea of the commerce related subjects, right? So for this, a small tip is, suppose you want to show the solution for your student. So click on the insert, click on the table. Okay, so you just select the table. For example, 6x4, I'm taking it. Here you can type the date, particulars, rupees or amount, date, particulars, rupees. So you can see now how you are able to see my screen when I share it. So in a similar way, your students will also be able to share, view whatever you are typing. So suppose for example, here I'm writing 2 capitals, some amount I'm writing, and I'm writing, okay, date, okay, by salaries, something like that. So in this way, you can show it to your students. So this you can do it in Word or PPT or any other thing. This is just a sample thing, right? So the next one is, just a second. This is how the various bonus tools are there. Okay, now I will have the same question which I have asked in the starting of the webinar. Can all the subjects be taught online? So I guess the answer to this question is answered by all the tools which we have discussed till now, right? Some of the tools can be used for some subjects. So it is like the question is answered, right? So with this, I would like to have a beautiful quotation by George Corus. This technology will not replace great teachers, but technology in the hands of great teachers can be transformational. So with this one, we will come to a new equation for teachers, that is teacher plus technology is equal to transformation. Now, all the tools which I have discussed till now are just a drop in the ocean of ICT tools which are available online. It is left for us to explore the tools and decide which tool is appropriate for our subject and for our students. It is up to you, and we can definitely see all the tools are coming up with free versions, and some of them are absolutely free, and some are having premium versions also. And if you are satisfied with a particular tool, you can even purchase that particular tool. And I guess it is the right time for all of us to invest our time and money in the digital assets like this and face the new normal, which all of us are facing right now in this COVID situation. We are slowly moving into a student-centered classroom from a traditional classroom model. Now, traditional classroom method is gone nowadays. Why? Because we are facing, all of us are aware of the situation, right? Even if now also some lecturers, if they are sticking to the methods of chalk and talk, that doesn't work, I guess. So for all these things, we are moving to a traditional classroom method, to a student-centered method. So for this to happen, there has to be a drastic change in the mindset of the people. And as an educationist, as a teachers, our mindset has to be changed. We cannot rely on the traditional chalk and talk method. We have to adopt to the change, because we should have a growth mindset. And as our students are radically changing, also it is a responsibility for us also. We should also change and adopt the new pedagogy of using ICT tools and adopt the new technologies which are coming, and say and do our duty to the best, right? So there is a complete shift to the technology driven classroom teaching. Now we are not going to see, hopefully the situations, if everything comes well, then we will be going to the traditional classroom method. But still, in the traditional classroom method also, we can use all these ITC tools which we have discussed, and we can engage the students, because we are teaching a digital native people. Our generation is what? Digital immigrants. We are the just adopters of the technology. When we were born, the technology was not up to this extent. But nowadays kids, they are well versed with the technology. So to teach them, to engage them, to make the subject interesting to them, we should change first, right? So the change, I guess change is the only thing which is constant in a life. And we should be the change, and let us change this technology, and we will shift to a technology driven teaching, right? So with this, I would like to end my webinar by telling you a statement that we need technology in every classroom and in every student and teacher's hand, because it is the pen and paper of our time, and it is the lens through which we experience much of our world, right? So thanks, a sincere thanks to all the participants who had bared me for so long. Thanks to all the participants, and my sincere thanks to Dr. Philomena ma'am, founder, director, and correspondent of Illamari Degree College, and Ms. Chinnamma ma'am, secretary of Illamari Degree College. And a special thanks to Revati Devi ma'am for all her support, and Mrs. Gayatri ma'am, head of the department computer science, who had been through the journey right from the invitation, everything. She has been supporting me a lot. And finally, the IQSC of Villamari Degree College for all the technical support which they have given. The IQSC team, like Atiya ma'am, IQSC coordinator, Naveen sir, Chandrashekhar sir, and Sayada ma'am, all thanks to all the people, and special thanks to all the participants. Thank you.
Ma'am, can you please repeat how to convert handwritten into Google Docs? Ma'am, can you please repeat how to convert our hand?
Repeat the question, ma'am. Can we convert the snipping tool file into PDF or MS Word file?
Ha, ma'am, yes, definitely. Because whatever snipping tool you have converted, the snipping tool, whatever you have done, that will be automatically saved into a JPG file. The JPG file you have to first convert into PDF, then from PDF you have to convert. From that you can do it all the things.
Thank
Hello,
you, ma'am.
Hello.
Hello, madam.
We have one more question. What is the difference between OBS and Glue? I repeat the question, ma'am. What is the difference between OBS and Glue?
Zoom is a Loom is a screencasting tool which is very useful. You can take the video and you can then share it to your students. That is the thing. And whereas just a second.
Hello. 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 Hello.
Hello.
Hello.
So there's
Hello?
A network problem.
Madam, good afternoon, madam.
Good afternoon, sir.
This is Manoj from Nizamabad, madam.
Yes, sir.
Any online tool for teaching accounting?
Accounting. See, sir, the whiteboard tools are available already.
Yeah.
In the whiteboard tool also you can use the table option will be there. You can use it.
Okay.
And just now I have shown you one thing, right? You can see whenever you are using Zoom or GoToMeeting like this, you will be sharing your screen. So
yeah,
obviously at that time you can open any Word document or PPT and directly insert a table and directly you can type the transactions whatever are there, then everything is visible to the student, sir.
Okay, ma'am.
Hello, ma'am.
Thank you very much, ma'am.
Thank you.
Madam,
hello, ma'am.
Will you share the PPT?
Question from
Madam, please.
Yes,
can you make PPT on Loom also?
Yeah, share
can
the PPT, ma'am.
PPT on Loom also?
No. Loom is for screencasting. In Nearpod, you can do the PPTs.
Okay.
Madam, please share the PPT,
thank you, ma'am.
Madam.
There's another. Yes, sir. The PPT will be shared, sir.
Hello.
Ma'am, can you please?
Hello.
There's another question from.
Yes, ma'am.
Can you please explain how to convert handwritten document to Google document? The process.
Yes, ma'am. Just a second, ma'am. I'm showing you. I'm sharing my screen again. So whatever document you have, see that works with Telugu, Hindi and English documents, ma'am. So if you have any English document or any other document, you just take a screenshot of that document, of that page, whatever it you have written, and upload it to Google Drive, ma'am. Send it as a mail to from your mobile phone, and from mail you download it, okay, and attach it to your Google Drive. Okay, I'm just showing you the demo. Okay, so after that image comes to your Google Drive, see, for example, here. For example, here I have a handwritten document in English, right? I have a JPG file. I have a picture. What you do, you just right click it. Just right click and open with Google Docs. Open with Google Docs. Open with Google Docs. It will be opening. Okay. So this is a picture what you have taken, and this is the converted text. If you want, you can delete this picture and you can download it. See, you can download it as a Word file and later you can edit all the documents, right? This is how you have to convert, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Is it answered, ma'am?
Thank you, ma'am. There's one more question. Google Drive GB storage, is there any other option to store?
Ma'am, the basic version of Google Drive is it will store only 15 GB of storage you have. But if you want, you can go with the G Suite. You can purchase any plan, which is very for a nominal account, ma'am. If you just go to the Google G Suite planning, for a basic user, if you want one email ID, it is around 125 per month. If you want to store more storage, then it is available, ma'am. That option is available. You can purchase the extra storage which you require. Or otherwise, what you can do is, even if you don't want to purchase it, what you can do, you can download everything and store it in your local computer. That also works fine.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
There's one more question. Is it possible to convert mathematics theorem with symbols into a Google document?
Yes, ma'am. The thing will be converted, but the problem comes with some expressions that I have tried, but some expressions were missing. But if the simple expressions are there, then that will get converted, ma'am. It is already available. Or you have a feature which comes automatically with the Windows operating system. You have something called as equation editor, ma'am. You have an option called as equation editor, which comes free with the Windows operating system. In that, you can type all kinds of equations and you can you can paste it in your Google Word documents. That is very simple to use.
Thank you very much, ma'am. There's yes, one ma'am. More question. Is there any tool on similar lines to select selections from a YouTube video and share with students instead of full video?
Yes, ma'am. Just now I told you, you can download any video from YouTube. You have the trimming options also available. You can download the YouTube video. Okay. Like in Edpuzzle and all those things we have seen, we can download the YouTube video. Whatever, instead of the complete video, we can select a particular thing and then we can save that video to a new file and we can share it with our students.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am. There's one more question. Which type of tool is used to deliver the subject and collect the feedback in questionnaire?
Ma'am, I did not get your question. Can you repeat it?
I repeat the question, ma'am. Which type of tool is ma'am. Used to deliver the subject and collect the feedback in questionnaire?
Questionnaire form.
Yes.
So, see, already to mention, Google Forms is also there for assessment tools. Right. I have not taken the topic. Why? Because still now everyone is well versed with Google Forms. Like you can simply create a Google form and send it to your students and you can get the responses from them. And there are so many other options apart from Google Form also, ma'am. Like you have SurveyMonkey, you have Typeform, you have so many other tools other than Google Form.
Yes. Thank you, ma'am. Another question, ma'am. Are there any limit to the number of students who can join these online classroom apps?
No, ma'am, it's not like that. We can have many number of students. When we send the code, how many students will join? It's up to them, ma'am. There is no limit.
Okay, ma'am, thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
I think all the questions from the participants have been answered.
Thank you, Gayatri ma'am. Good afternoon, everyone. Allow me to introduce myself. I am Mrs. Atiya Nusrat, IQAC coordinator, Villamari Degree College. Before I propose a vote of thanks to everyone here, I would like Mrs. Renuka to please accept this memento of appreciation for your valuable confab.
Thank you, ma'am.
On behalf of Villamari Degree College for IQAC, I deem it as a grand privilege to propose a vote of thanks. First and foremost, I would like to thank Dr. Philomena ma'am for her able guidance and for her penchant of learning. I would like to thank Mrs. Revati Devi Mathur for her constant support and overwhelming motivation. I would like to thank Head Department of Computer Science, Mrs. Gayatri, for her valuable contribution and efforts. My congenial thanks to our keynote speaker, Mrs. Renuka, for having endured your precious times and obliging to the webinar. Technology and it is now the window to the world, and today we have been certainly enlightened with your insight-driven session reflecting the true essence of innovative pedagogy. A big applause to all the wonderful audience for being the patient listeners throughout, and a huge round of appreciation to and immense gratitude as well to our forerunners, the IQAC team. The team behind this flawless session, thank you for your logistics and support. I request Mr. Naveen to please share the feedback link. The feedback link is provided in the chat box and also on the screen. Kindly fill the feedback form and ensure that you will be generating an e-certificate. If there are any queries to the e-certificate, kindly mail us after 1 week at the address given on the screen, iqacvmtc@gmail.com, after 1 week. Please reach us for further queries at iqacvmtc@gmail.com. Until then, stay safe, stay home, take care, everyone. Good afternoon.
I think